Now, I think one of the great features that I actually came about doing was the heel itself that we talked about earlier on. Now, this little cutting, as it were, chalk face cutting, if we just get a look at this, that's quite a simple effect, and all that was achieved by was an old ice cream container that we actually plunked on the corner of the layout, and then we covered with papier-mâché various bits of cardboard and paper to build up a heel. But I deliberately left the front flat face, and with an open colour left by the Lanfon bandage, which is the same stuff as when you go to a hospital and you break a leg or an arm, they put around your bones and stuff to make them heal. So what I did, I left the front face of the little cliff deliberately white to simulate chalk, and then we covered the whole thing with lichen and various different coloured materials, and you've got this wonderful little cutting now that adds dimension and profile to the model. And then perched precariously on top of it, we've got the windmill. This windmill is another of the limited edition models that you can get from Scaledow, which unfortunately is, I believe, no longer available, only in N-gauge, that I managed to pick up again from Norwood Junction Models. It's quite an enjoyable feature of the layout, and at some stage we would like to have it actually working and have the sails rotating and some lights in there maybe, but again, it's another idea and project for another day, probably. Now, sadly and unfortunately, I haven't got enough room to display all my locomotives and running models that I've actually got. There's quite a few more that I want to put out, but we've not got the room. So they remain in the boxes. But we do have my two models that we can actually get working and are wonderful. Now, one of the interesting features about the locos and tender, particularly tender locos that I have in the layout, is the addition of actual real coal within the tender. Now, I think the real thing looks much more effective, and that is actually real coal found whilst out and about on the railway. And I think it's a wonderful feature that looks good in the tenders and also within all of our coal wagons, which we have situated over on the good side in on number one road over here, loaded up. Also about the floor, looks quite realistic, I think.